from pole position for Epsilon, the man Mark Marquez. Jack Miller got away well from that second row. Miller looks like he's only up in the second place as they sweep down into the doing corner. Marquez definitely got the whole shot. Andrea, you know, still drag from the line, but Jack Miller was superb from fifth on the grid. Here he is, down in the brakes for turn four for the first time. Valentino Rossi aggressive up the inside of Paul Espargaro. Rossi's had a good start. He's already now up in the fifth place. But Miller leads the way up through Siberia. He comes up over the rise. Then he run along that top end of the... Nowhere to go, turning on the inside. Jack Miller then sweeps through the final corner for the first time, down the famous Gardner Straight. The crowd going ballistic here in Australia. Jack Miller leads here over the line at the end of lap one. Rossi and Iannone cross the line. Marquez in second place. Third, Vinales, Rossi, Iannone, Paul Espargaro, Sarko Crutchlow, Aleix Espargaro. And then we have Iannone. They accelerate up towards Siberia. Marquez will not be too unhappy that it's Jack Miller leading the way rather than one of his championship runs. Run wide. He's having a disaster, Dovizioso. He's down at 20th place. That is crucial. Marquez second, Dovizioso now in 20th place. The championship is slipping away from the Ducati riders. They come across the line. Miller to the cheers of the crowd, still leads the way as they race down towards the Doohan corner.
Marquez on turn number four. We know Johan Zarco super, super aggressive. Vinales found his way through on Marquez at turn four. No way through, though, for Zarco. Marquez lost two places there.
To Espargaro. Two Yamahas going well, though, in these conditions with Rossi and, of course, Vinales, and also Zarco fighting his way back. Mark Marquez recovered his composure and now will start fighting back against the Yamaha. As it comes down to the start and finish straight. Gardner straight into turn one. Marquez up the inside of Rossi. Absolutely not an inch as they come into the hairpin. Zarco up the inside. He makes it stick this time. There's nowhere for Aleix Espargaro to go. Remember on the previous lap, he touched up Mark Marquez in a similar move. Here is Andrea Dovizioso. He has Dovizioso ready. Battista Barbara Lowe and Brock Parks.
What a job by Carol Abraham there. He's the top Ducati at the moment, 11th and 12th place.
We ride with a Valentino Mark Marquez with two rounds of the championship remaining, but these result places are not going to remain the same because Valentino Rossi has moved into second place past his teammate Maverick Vinales at the hairpin.
Yeah, and the gap's coming down to Jack Miller as well. Jack Miller's advantage has been slashed in half now. He leads by just under half a second. What, 6 weeks ago, and here they are in the Australian Grand Prix, one and two.
And I tell you what, if you look at that top group of six, he is the only one with that medium rear tyre, so
10 metres over the line before he got slipstreamed by his teammate Vinales. Rossi moves to the inside at turn number four. He's lunging up the inside on the brakes. Rossi's found his way back into the lead. Oh, is he a little bit wide? No, he holds firm.
Valentino Rossi leads here at Phillip Island, the man that won here in 2014. Up over the rise they come at Siberia. What a start to the...
Yeah, it looked like Jack Miller was getting a bit of wheel spin coming out of that final corner there. He didn't have the drive grip at all, did he? The Yamahas didn't even need the slipstream to blitz by Jack Miller down the Gardner Straight. Vinales just held his nerve on the brakes. You've got to be pretty strong and aggressive to outbreak Valentino Rossi going into the Doohan corner. Is Marquez about to pounce on Vinales at that Doohan corner? Listen there from Jack Miller. That's super aggressive, giving Johan Zarco a taste of his own medicine in many respects. But Zarco's got the inside line for Siberia, so he's going to cling on to that fourth place.
Zarco looks very, very dangerous indeed. He had that bit of a coming together, didn't he, with Mark Marquez earlier in the race, but he is absolutely flying now.
There's Dovizioso then, Andrea Dovizioso still. He's just actually got in the points, Dovizioso. He's picked off Tito Rabat. Mark Marquez attacks Valentino Rossi on the run down to the Doohan corner. The Doohan corner.
I was really focusing on Marquez. Oh, Marquez opens the door up a little bit and Zarco says, well, I messed it up last time at the hairpin. I'm not messing it up this time. The Moto2 world champion up into second place and Marquez relegated to third.
It was hardly even let. Look how wide the laser spot. Crutchlow said yesterday, if he can hang on to that lead group in the first half of the race, watch out for him. He fancies a chance of a repeat success from last year because his time management
at crucial points, aren't they?
Down at turn four then for the ninth time of asking, and Jack Miller up the inside of Maverick Vinales. Rossi's out wide then at turn four. Rossi out wide. Now, was it a mistake or was he given a helping hand by your new race leader, Johan Zarco? But Valentino Rossi, what's not in dispute is he's dropped back down to third place. Zarco come through from 13th on the grid to 8th place. He's right on the back of this lead group. The gap between Zarco at the front of the race and Rins in 8th. In a long time in this lead group is a sight of a single Ducati. Miller then up the inside of Valentino Rossi. Beautifully done on the brakes there by Miller. He ends up in the third place. Mark Marquez has a good long look over his left shoulder. What he will see, he'll get a face full of the number 43 of Jack Miller. Get a face full of beach. That reminds us about the tyres, Dylan, down in pit lane, Zarco and Marquez.
Well, exactly so. Marquez has that soft option rear, as does Johann Zarco as well. Marquez has the medium front, Zarco has the soft front. And as Dunlop, excuse me, as Michelin told us, after 20 laps, that's when they expect to see the drop-off. Oh.
Sadly, when he won that race in Austria, the race he had here a couple of years ago, 27 points would be the advantage of Marc Marquez if these positions are just to pick up some vital World Championship points.
Yeah, that's the battle for 11. That was Pedrosa retaliating on Dovizioso. Dovizioso had found his way through on Dani Pedrosa.
Back at the front, Zarco still leads the way. Marquez right in his face as they come down the Gardner straight towards the Doohan corner. We ride with Maverick Vinales.
It's going to be crucial to try and retain heat in those tyres. Jack Miller running a wider line. Valentino Rossi thought about nipping up the inside. There was no way through.
I tell Marquez, you what, Andrea,
Marquez again coming out of turn number four has a good long look over his left shoulder. I'm not sure what he expects to see because he must know from his pit bull that thinking, where is my championship rival? That might be coming into Marquez's head in terms of the risk he's willing to take in these final 15 laps. That might be what he was looking back for, just to see if he could, the first 15 laps, which we're getting close to, he would be strong and competitive. He was worried about the lack of electronic sophistication on that Suzuki. Rossi fights back on Miller when he was going to run into some major wheel spin issues. That's been one of the weaknesses of that Suzuki package this year, Andrea Iannone.
At some point, Marquez is going to make a move, isn't it? It's probably way
for 11th, a long, long way behind Pol Espargaró in 10th place.
We ride with Andrea Dovizioso. These are crucial, crucial points for him and at the outcome of the World Championship. Yeah, Marquez, he does know what really want to know where Dovizioso is, because does he take too much of a risk? Rossi is back into second place. As they corner, they come and they sit up a break. Rossi on the brakes at the inside of Zarco. Valentino Rossi takes the lead here at Phillip Island.
Yeah, classic block pass by Rossi on the brakes going into turn number four. This top eight have a right good old thing, though, as they are having. You can't say that Brad himself have any chance of getting in the points at the moment.
Well, the Australian crowd, they're cheering Jack Miller, but they love Valentino Rossi. And Rossi literally breathless. This is motorsport and it's absolute peak. You just don't get better than this. And here we go, Marquez up the inside, up the hairpin. No way that Zarco can fight back. And he opens the door up a little bit. Maverick Vinales thinks about and have a go at him, but he's not able to. But Marquez back into second place as they come up over
in this battle.
It is, it is. We'd love to get all romantic about it, but this is Phillip Island. This is at the very top, and Andrea Dovizioso.
But that early mistake has really done for his chances.
Marquez is nice and close to Rossi. We go around the Stoner corner, we arrive in Marquez. Can he get up the inside on the brakes? I don't think he is quite close enough.
Zarco picks his pocket at turn four again.
Just as we were looking at Marquez, thinking who's going to go past Rossi, Zarco beat his classic Phillip Island move there by Maverick Vinales, a former winner here, third in the race here last year. Bonamaluki Heights up the inside on the brakes and he's made it stick.
Please, please, please don't rain here in Phillip Island.
He took the words out of my mouth. The two Yamahas. Valentino Rossi, we ride with him right in his face, number five. Johann Zarco, here comes Zarco up the inside. Johann Zarco leads the French Grand Prix once again.
He's brilliant on that soft front tyre, isn't he, Zarco? Got a great feeling going into that turn number four. He's made so many manoeuvres there. This time he's up the inside of Rossi, up in the fourth place.
These are absolutely crucial positions for Marquez and crucial for Dovizioso. Okay, Poggiarada, team boss of Tech 3.
For the medium front tyre. Just a reminder, Michelin said that with about seven laps to go, that is when they expect a drop off from those on the softer option rear.
Valentino Rossi retakes this, sits Iannone up.
You can barely pause the breath.
He proper sits him up there at turn 10. We come back with Andrea Dovizioso. He's the most level-headed man you'd ever wish to meet, and he'll know exactly what the situation is, and he knows that he's
so strong in corners like the Southern Loop. He's been brilliant there all race long.
He certainly has. They break hard now for the chicane. Rossi lighting up
Vinales. No, not close enough.
You know he's given Zarco a nudge there. That's Kosciuszko and Zarco fourth place. You know they're on the charge again. He got up the inside of Zarco at turn four.
I tell you what, Crutchlow's not out of it as well.
And Marc Marquez in one manoeuvre. Dovizioso cannot rest. He's coming under intense pressure here from Dani Pedrosa. Dani Pedrosa, of course, will be desperate to help out his teammate Marc Marquez.
Sort of speed round the left hand.
Yeah, they run because Valentino Rossi lost momentum. Rossi lost drive coming out the southern loop. They definitely run. That cost Rossi two places because he dropped back into fourth behind Andrea Iannone as well. Can you believe it? It's been a breathless opening 19 and a half laps. At this stage of the race, the top back into third place. Zarco back in the hunt as well.
Two Spanish riders though, one on a Yamaha, one on a Honda, lead the way. As Egg Marquez, he said yesterday in the dry that Marc Marquez was by far the faster rider. Clearly found something to get a bit more tire life out of that Michelin rear tire for the Yamaha. That's been their problem, of course, all year. Marquez is attacking at turn four and he's got through. Marquez, as he just run it a little bit wide, now there's no way for Vinales to fight back. They run down now to Siberia. Ted Rossi, they're back in the second place. He does not want to let Marc Marquez get away at the front here, Rossi.
He knows what Marc Marquez's plan would be now. I suppose everybody knows. It doesn't take a Maverick Vinales. He was leading the way. He's not leading the way now, is he? Marquez, Rossi, Zarco.
Races this year, the Yamaha struggle for endurance and tyre life on that rear tyre. Holding pretty firm right now, you have to say.
Yeah, Rossi looks very comfortable in second place at the moment. Zarco, as always, absolutely giving it all. Andrea Iannone, we haven't seen Andrea Iannone ride.
The southern loop is Rossi just struggling for a little bit of grip. They do get wheels finishes at this stage of the race, do the Yamaha.
Here comes Zarco up the inside of Rossi. Can Zarco make it sticky?
As they drop down through Lukey Heights for the 23rd time of asking.
Marquez at the bottom of Lukey Heights, up towards turns 11 and 12. There is Zarco, Rossi, Iannone on the Suzuki. Vinales has just dropped out of the fray a little bit.
Yeah, he might have run out of steam and run out of rear grip here, Matt Vinales, and the back. Yeah, Dani Pedrosa is suffering. He's dropped down into the 132s last time around. I don't know if he made a mistake. But Scott Redding, will he take points off Andrea Dovizioso? But at the moment, running in seventh place, making no impression on Vinales ahead of him for that top six.
Well, this is our look at Zarco from the rear wheel of the Yamaha. Valentino Rossi, you see Iannone there in fourth place. Interesting to see what the gap is. They crossed the line with three laps ago because Marquez has got that hammer down. Gap from the helicopter, as you can see, as they come around the stone corner. Rossi, Iannone, Zarco. Oh, if Andrea Iannone could put that Suzuki on the podium here, there would be great celebrations on the podium. Andrea Iannone has moved up into second place, but then runs it a bit wide. Iannone and Zarco. And here comes Zarco at the bottom of Lukey Heights, up the inside of Iannone. Rossi thinks about following soon, not able to get through. We ride with Zarco. Goal number 29 could not be closer.
Massive swing in the championship as well. Marquez now leading. Scott Redding has taken Andrea Dovizioso for 11th place. 32 points. The advantage Marc Marquez would have at Iannone. That great KTM fight going on as well between Pol Espargaro and Bradley Smith. Pol Espargaro's got it to ninth. Dovizioso fights back on Scott Redding. That's going to be 11th place for Andrea Dovizioso, who's under a serious attack again from Redding, and Dani Pedrosa will not want to relinquish these two places. Rossi and Zarco get very, very close to touching again.
Rossi, Iannone coming under a fair bit of pressure now from Vinales. Crutchlow, Miller, Rins, Pol Espargaro, Bradley Smith. That is your top 10.
Last time out in Japan.
Here, I can absolutely promise you, he also got a glimpse there of Dani Pedrosa.
Here's this three-way Yamaha fight raging for second place. Look at the tight defensive line there, Rossi.
Second place, here they come.
Again, Rossi.
Brilliant stuff from Rossi.
Superb defensive riding by Valentino Rossi. Surely there's no way he's going to lose that second place. What a ride by Rossi. Didn't think he was going to be in that victory fight, but it's all about one man, all about the reigning world champion, Marc Marquez, taking a giant stride towards this year's title.
He's got two hands, less one finger on that trophy. Marquez wins a magnificent race here.
Real good fight. What about Andrea Dovizioso? Dovizioso was passed on the final lap by Scott Redding and Dani Pedrosa. His day just went from bad to worse.
Well, it's been a bad day, but that is an absolute disaster.
Four races, it was the first time in 10 years they had not had a podium in three successive races, but Rossi puts that record straight, and Vinales taking third place from Johan Zarco, right, Rossi.
The gap between the three Yamaha men over the line was less than a tenth of a second. But that was a monumental day for the championship, with Marc Márquez winning.